But before publishing our findings in Gothamist, WNYC's partner publication, we reached out to the mayor's office for comment, which led to this.
New York City Mayor Bill de Blasio has launched an investigation into the NYPD.
Mayor Bill de Blasio says any ties to Oath Keepers will disqualify the officers from serving the city.
Your office has launched an investigation, you confirmed, but could you tell us more about the scope of that investigation?
This is WNYC host Brian Lair interviewing Mayor de Blasio last Friday.
Will it be limited to just the two officers the story mentions, or will it involve going into the data and looking for more possible names?
If we confirm that any police officer has pledged allegiance to Oath Keepers and to those values, then it's time. There'll be due process. Of course, they deserve a trial, but we're not going to go through all the ranks of NYPD looking for what people's political values are. That smacks of McCarthyism to me. And I said yesterday, my parents went through the McCarthy era and were victims of McCarthy.
You can go through the list of the people that donated to the Oath Keepers and just fire them all.
After we broke this story, a flood of reports began uncovering other potential law enforcement ties across the country.
Good, catch them.
An editor at a major Utah newspaper messaged me asking for advice for how to do this type of reporting in his state. BuzzFeed News found names matching officers in Washington State and Louisiana who are being sued for civil rights violations.
You get to find out who they are, or we'll find out who they are.
Ties between the group and a sheriff in Southern California.
Riverside County Sheriff Chad Bianco is one of hundreds of law enforcement officials caught on a list of leaked membership
names.
Records for the Oath Keepers.
He says he did pay for a one-year membership to the group back in
2014. It'll all be in an app soon.
But
he'll never get a job anywhere.
Himself from the Oath Keepers, he doesn't disavow
make welfare
either,
good because you're going to need
quote,
it.
What happened on January 6th by a few people should have nothing to do with something I did in 2014.
Yeah, except you supported a terrorist organization.
The
nope,
and
terrorism.
Particularly optimistic. That a leaked membership log will spur law enforcement around the country to think about this issue.
They don't have to think about it. People can think about it. We can find out who all these people are.
And individual members around the country being involved in extremism. This isn't new by any means.
But being able to track them down is new.
Extremism is one that is politically.
They weren't ready for this.
There is not agreement that Oath Keepers, for example, are extremists. The same
only because the right-wing party is extremist.
Okay, so it's completely futile.
It's not completely futile. I can certainly imagine that New York City takes action regarding this sort of thing in a way that, let's say, a county sheriff's office in upstate New York doesn't take
you
action.
Arrested a deputy
right,
mayor
the politics of the
in Antioch, New York,
just different
with fake FBI badges,
change in law enforcement,
illegal weapons
will only happen when
and
we
you
have
let him out.
Systemic change in American political culture.
I don't think it's just political culture, it's change in the culture.
I also wasn't surprised by the notion that cops might be members of the Oath Keepers.
When people start arresting cops,
it might make me sound kind of naive.
It's on.
As we dug into the names on that hacked list, it was the broader picture that gave me pause. Programmers, nurses, doctors, lawyers, security guards, investment bankers, carpenters, CEOs, blue collar, white collar, rural and urban.
Terrorists.
There's a guy in the list who lives on my street in Brooklyn. Oath
Keepers,
shown to undermine the rule of law in the name of a distorted, diminished.
But let's call them terrorists, and let's get the war on terror against them. Let's get some predator drones. Let's get General Milley after them. Let's do this.
For On the Media, I'm Michael Lowinger.
Just laugh about having a terrorist living down the street from you.